Vayikra, ideas in the realm of Gematria from the Parsha and Daf Yomi. Continuing article number four with the idea of finding something in the Parsha and connecting it with the Daf Yomi of that week. So any Daf in the week of this Parsha Vayikra and finding some connection to the Parsha. And so far, it's followed the same pattern that it's been every Friday. So Friday's Daf, and it works out well because it's going right into Shabbos. So those who learn Daf Yomi are actually have it fresh in their mind when Shabbos comes. But the Pasuk says, if a person, v'nefesh ki sakriv korban mincha, l'Hashem, solas yi a korbano, Yitzhak aleha shemen, v'nasan aleha levona. And if a person brings a meal offering to the Lord, his offering shall be of fine flour. He shall pour oil over it and place frankincense upon it. Leviticus 2:1. Daf Yomi has moved from the first perek called Shnayim Ochsin, which dealt initially with two individuals in dispute about finding the same object, and moved on to various other disputes of loans and taking an oath in court, denying loans, and then having to take an oath, and touching upon other topics that include finding a divorce document, emancipation of slaves, document of receipts, among many other things. And we move to the second perek, which is called Elu Metzias, which deals with finding objects and the obligation to make a public announcement in order to find its rightful owner. Bava Metzia, Daf 23a, brings a case of finding bread in a public place. Please keep in mind that in those days, bread and food in general may not have been in as abundant supply as we today in modern developed countries, thankfully, have it. Finding bread in the street could have been a big deal for many. And the words in here is Tashema, Kikros shel nachtom, bread of bread of a baker. They belong to him. But bread of a baal bayis, you have to announce. So the Gemara suggests, come and hear a proof in the Mishnah, that if one's found baker's loaves, those belong to him, the Gemara says that you can keep it. If you find loaves of a homeowner, you have to proclaim it. Because if it's commercially made, it's like they're all the same. But if it's a person's own bread, it's like it has a distinguishing mark. It's like each person has their own bread in a way. And so the idea is that a person themselves, it's like each person is a nefesh. And the famous or the line in the Gemara is Demida yada rifta de inish, inishu, that each person knows their own bread. That, and maybe in those days it was like a village, so it's not like today. I mean, if you find some bread, I'm not going to say that it's this person down the street, oh, they bake a bread a certain way. This is like conceptual, I think, as far as today we're concerned. But the point is that a person, their own personality is put into the bread. They're nefesh. And that's the connection. The connection is from the verse in our parsha that says that if a nefesh will make a korban mincha. Now that a korban mincha is made from flour, and bread is made from flour. That's the connection. So a meal offering would offered if it's just a mincha, not a mincha with the daily sacrifice or whatever. It's just a person's mincha. Usually they would be having less means. They'd be a lower economic status. And so Rashi points out in this verse that all of the other sacrifices, the korban mincha meal offering. It's the only word that nefesh is used is because a person who's considered a poor person did not have means to bring an animal sacrifice, and would be allowed to bring this, less expensive, made of flour. And so Hashem considers it that he gave it with his full nefesh, because it's all he had, or she had. So it's that's why it says nefesh. So going into the more Kabbalistic side, in Kabbalistic teaching, there are 5 levels of the soul. And nefesh is really at the bottom of the barrel. I mean, nefesh is like every animal has a nefesh. Nefesh chaya. It's like nefesh is the basic life force. It's a non-physical, like, energy, but it's there's 5 levels of the soul. There's nefesh, and then goes ruach, which is loosely translated as wind or spirit. Ruach neshama, that's the soul. That's the already the higher level. Neshama chaya. Chaya would be translated as like the life force, but it's higher than the soul. It's not nefesh life force. It's a life that's more sublime. Chaya means like life, and then yechida is like the unique. It comes from yechid. It's unique essence. That's the most sublime. It's the most non. It's the most ethereal. The highest up on the level of the 5 levels of soul. So of these 5 levels of nefesh, so nefesh is the one who starts by making this mincha. But if we take a look in Gematria, we might find that behind the word nefesh, or within the word nefesh, are hiding all the other levels. How do we see all 5 levels hiding within nefesh? Okay? We find it specifically with the Korban Mincha. If you take out your calculator, your Gematria calculators. Personally, mine is down today. I don't know what happened. I think a lot of the sites are down today. All the Gematria calculators are down, but hopefully they'll get back up. But if you could do it on pen and paper or whatever. Korban Mincha is Gematria value 455. And 455. Korban is 352. Mincha is 103. The three highest levels, which are Neshama, Chaya, and Yechida, if you add those together, it equals exactly Korban Mincha. Okay? Korban Mincha, 455, Neshama, Yechida, and Chaya, 455. What about Ruach? In Gematria, we find it there too. We have an expression in Psalms 31:6 that says, Biyadcha avkid ruchi. It's part of a song also. Biyado avkid ruchi. But the words, Biyadcha avkid ruchi, into your hands I entrust my spirit. You have the word avkid ruchi, ruach. The words, Biyadcha avkid ruchi, has an exact value of 455. But what about the word nefesh itself? That's covered as well. If you take the words ha-nefesh haya, the nefesh was, that equals 455. Or you can also alternative. You can say, and this might be more accurate. Zehu nafsho. This is his soul. Zehu nafsho. This is his nefesh, which actually it has an exact value of 454. But in the laws in the rules of Gematria, if you have two words, you can actually use that sum. As an extra word, it's called kololim, and we learned that from a verse in Genesis. But basically, zehu hanefesh is equal to 454. With the kol, it's 455. So really, zehu nafsho. I'm sorry, zehu nafsho. This is his soul. Is equal to korban mincha. So within korban mincha, within the word nefesh, you have all 5 levels of the soul. Have a great Shabbos and happy Purim.